running down its wrist like that god's blood river. 2016 was some cosmic crossover, right? Some bellowing beast of compressed time, some long-forgotten witch, scorned, adorned in tokens of pieces of our world, lost my dad's suicide note, dangling from her earlobes, necklace strung from the tears shed at my best friend's funeral, brooch carved from my grandmother's tombstone, baby teeth clipped into her mossy hair, this swamp woman just cackling and blowing, perched silent at the edge of all of our houses, like hell had no fury, like recent rise in death toll surprises experts, like New Year's Day rain expected to wash away the wreckage, like maybe I don't have anything left to wash away. Thank you guys. Like she said, we're an organization that aims to increase literacy across Southern California and the world by engaging teens through classic poetry, and that's because we believe that the voices of our youth are the most important voices that we have. Where are my ladies at? How many times have I been asked a question and the man next to me has plucked my words from the air as I dared to speak them, picked and pulled my voice from between my lips, sucked the air from my lungs and boasted his own puffed chest, and we, the deflated women, are to be thankful for his noble intentions, grateful for a swift pat on the hand, the weight of our own voices taken off of our shoulders. See, there's an heirloom in a glass case in all of our houses, passed down through this still silence, through this family of forget, the age-old belief that women are not to speak in a man's presence. But today, well, today we throw stones. Today we break our glass houses and burn the wreckage. Today we sing the solidarity of sisterhood, line our bedrooms in protest signs, keep war paint always in our back pockets. Girl, look at what they couldn't kill. Beam worth, devour space, birth new oceans for our daughters to explore. Revolution lives in that plump, seasoned heart of yours. You just have to uncage it. Don't just lean in. Stand up. Reach out in front of him and take your words back. Hear how you echo without an apology to quiet you. Don't just take up space. Be space. Demand. Demand. See, my vocal cords are no longer foreign instruments to me. Perched as a celestial harp atop my chest, today they're a soul, a part of who I am. Every step I take makes a sound, and together we can build an unabashed orchestra, a sapphic symphony of self-love. Together we reclaim, together we rise, and together we speak. Thank you.